for checking out my channel. Thank you for clicking on this video. This video is part of the series of videos I post to try to help people out when it comes to aptitude tests like the civil service exam. And today we're going to talk about something that you guys voted last week. Now, I usually post polls at the end of the videos that I make in which you can vote for which topic you want me to talk about next. And last time you guys said that you wanted something about factoring techniques. Now, I covered this a little bit. There's a discussion on the smallest terms of fractions, but it really wasn't that in-depth enough. So I wanted to teach you guys some of the techniques that helped me reduce factors to fractions to lowest terms. And also, this type of technique will also help you out pagdating sa factoring ng exponents and ng radicals. So maybe makakatulong to sa inyo, especially if you're preparing for a test, kasi ayaw natin nag-deal with big numbers. And I'm going to teach you some of my speed techniques today. Now, as always, there will be a quick little poll at the end of the video for you guys to decide which topic I would talk about next. This is not my usual new setup, but I'm actually moving things around, kaya medyo dugyot ako at haggard, pasensya na kayo. We're actually traveling to Malaysia tonight, and I'm still packing my things up, but I really wanted to leave something for you guys to study while I'm away. Now, there will be a quiz at the end of the video, so if you stay until the end, you'll have access to that free quiz, alright? So before we talk about that, thank you guys for watching, and thank you for all of you guys who are sharing yung channel na ito. Right now, we're just a few subscribers away from hitting 15,000, and I did promise that there will be a giveaway once we hit 15,000, and that is what we're going to do. So stay tuned for the announcement doon sa promo na yon. Alright? Now, next, we're going to discuss kung ano yung pag-uusapan natin today. I'm going to switch over to my PC so I can show you better. I'll see you in a bit.
Alright, so today we're going to talk about factoring techniques, numbers 2, 3, 4, and 5. The other numbers, 6, 7, 8, and onwards, they're going to be discussed in the next video, no? The reason is because if you're not familiar with this technique and these four numbers at the beginning, it's going to be harder for you to deal with the bigger numbers. So ang goal natin ngayon is for you to master these four para pagdating sa bigger numbers, ready na kayo. Alright? Now, iisa-isayin ko sa inyo yung rules for each number, and if you find it hard to figure out, that's okay. That's why I put it up on YouTube, kasi you can watch it again and again until you understand it. Alright? And again, at the end of the video, we're going to have a free quick quiz. So make sure that you watch until the end para ma-access nyo yon. Kasi it's best for you to practice on your spare time. A lot of my students would tell me na, Coach, when I hear your voice or when you're in front of us teaching us live, it's easy to understand ko ano yung concept, madali lang din sagutan, pero bakit pag ako na lang mag-isa nahihirapan ako? Now, the key there really is personal practice. So you have to set aside time to practice. Alright? Now, let's talk about itong frequent factors natin. We're going to talk about 2, 3, 4, and 5. And again, if you want to deal with the bigger numbers, dapat ma-master nyo ito. Kaya iisa-isayin natin sila. Alright, so the first one na discuss natin is if it is divisible by 2. Now, this is actually fairly easy kasi, ano to eh, something that we discussed earlier in childhood, no? Pero, i-establish natin kasi again, you have to master the entire thing. So, ang pag-uusapan natin ngayon, in order for you to know if a number is divisible by 2, you have to determine the rule. Ang rule for divisible by 2 na numbers is if it is even. So, if you're not familiar with your numbers, meron tayong odd numbers, meron tayong even numbers. If a number is odd, then it is not divisible by 2. If it is even, then it is divisible by 2. Now, how do you know that? A number is even if yung kanyang ending na number is also an even number. Ano ibig sabihin nun? If ang ending or ang dulong digit is 0, 2, 4, 6, and 8, then it is even. If hindi siya yung mga numbers na yan, then it is not divisible by 2 and it is not even. Now, here's what we're going to do today. I'm going to give you a list of numbers right here on the side, and then we're going to determine if they are divisible by the number that we're talking about. Okay, together. So, ang gagawin natin, iisa-isayin natin ito to figure out kung divisible ba siya sa 2. Now, this number here, number 8, it is not divisible by 2 kasi 8 yung ending na number or yung dulong digit niya. And if you check it, 8 divided by 2 is 4. Ang ibig sabihin lang ng divisible is whole number dapat yung magiging sagot. 8 divided by 2 is 4. So, ibig sabihin nun, it is divisible by 2. So, check tayo dyan. Okay? Now, 27. Ano ang dulong number niya? Ang dulong number niya ay 7. And 7 is not divisible by 2. Kasi 7 divided by 2 is, I'm going to give you 3.5. Again, 0.5. So, ibig sabihin nun, may butal. And again, this is an odd number. So, hindi siya even, hindi siya divisible by 2. Okay? I want you to get the hang of it. Now, 925 naman tayo. 925, dulong number is 5. 5 divided by 2, hindi pwede. This is going to give you 2.5. Decimal din yan, hindi din pwede. And again, odd number siya. So, x. Again, the more you do it, the faster you get. So, 0, again, pasok siya doon. So, pwede siya. 6, pasok siya. So, pwede siya sa 2. Anong ibig sabihin nun? If you are reducing a fraction into lowest terms, for example, you have 5280, kunyari lang ha, 5280 over 12326, to reduce it to lowest terms, you can divide both sides by 2. You can start with that. And then go and go and go. Alright? So that is sa 2. Lilipat naman tayo sa 3. Now this is a little bit trickier, but I know you can figure it out. A number is divisible by 3. Ito ang rule. The rule is, if the sum of its digits is divisible by 3. Now, a few things I need to point out. If the sum of its digits, ano ibig sabihin nun? Bawat isang digit, i-add mo siya together to get it. And then, yung mismong sum, yung pinagdugtong-dugtong, yun ang magiging rule dun magbabase if it's divisible by 3. So, ano yung digits niya? And if it is divisible by 3. So, 8, okay, divided by 3, hindi pwede. Okay? So, this is not divisible by 3. Next number tayo, 2 and 7 or 27. So, ang gagawin lang natin is we're going to add 2 and 7. So, 2 plus 7 is 9. And then, 9 divided by 3 is pwede. Kasi 9 divided by 3 is going to give you 3. Okay? Then, this is divisible by 3. 2 plus 7. I-add mo lahat ng digits. Next number tayo. Okay, ang next number natin is 925. Again, it looks complicated kung ita-trial and error mo siya. Pero again, ang gagawin lang natin, i-add natin lahat ng digits. So, 9 plus 2 plus 5 is equal to 9 plus 2 is 11 plus 5 is 16. Now, yung 16 divided by 3, hindi siya pwede. Okay, kasi 15 pwede, pero 16 hindi. May butal. Pag may butal or may remainder or may decimal, hindi. So, this is not divisible by 3. Okay? Now, level up tayo. Again, this is an even bigger number. You have 5280. So, anong gagawin natin? I-add natin siya lahat. 5 plus 2 plus 8 plus 0. 5 plus 2 is 7. Plus 8 is going to give us 15. And 15 divided by 3, pwede na. Kasi that is 5. So, ibig sabihin nun, this number is divisible by 3. Next. 1, 2, 3, 2, 6. Again. Looks complicated, malaki yung number, but it's really fast. Ang gagawin lang natin, i-add natin sila lahat. So, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 2 plus 6. So, here you have 3 plus 3, 6. Dalawang 6, 12 plus 2 is 14. Okay? 14 divided by 3 is hindi pwede kasi may butal. Okay? Anong gagawin natin? Ang gagawin na natin is hindi na cross out na natin to. Hindi na siya divisible sa 3. Okay? Bakit? Kasi ang magiging divisible lang sa 3 ay any number na may sum ng digits na divisible by 3 rin. Okay? So again, anong kailangan tandaan? The sum of the digits has to be divisible by 3. Now you know how to deal with the number 3. Taas tayo ng level onte, punta tayo sa 4. Again, may rule siya. A common mistake is most people think na basta even number pwede sa 4. And that's not true, okay? There are even numbers na hindi pwede sa 4. For example, 6. 6 divided by 4 is 1 and a half. So, hindi siya pwede kasi meron siyang butal. So, ano ang rule? Ang rule is, if the last two digits are divisible by 4. Again, anong titingnan natin? Yung last two digits. Ngayon, paano kung isang digit lang siya like 8? Ay, okay lang yan, no problem. Kasi, kung ano lang yung digit na meron. So, 8 divided by 4, pwede ba? 2. So, it's really basic. Pwede. Taas tayo ng level 27. Again, anong gagawin natin? Look at the last two digits. So, in this case, it's not that helpful pa. Kasi divide mo siya sa 4, meron kang butal. Kasi you'd know na 24 ang 6, 28 ang next. So, kulang siya. So, this is not divisible by 4. Okay? Hindi siya pwede may butal kasi may decimal. Ngayon, taas tayo ng level uli. This is going to be helpful pag ganito. Pag alam yung technique at ganito yung number, tatlong digits, mas madali. Okay? Bakit? Kasi you're going to look at the last two digits. Ano yung last two digits niya? 25. So, kalimutan nyo muna yung 9. Is 25 divisible by 4? Hindi. Kasi 24. Pwede. Pero 25, hindi. So, anong gagawin nun? Ibig sabihin nun, ang 925 is not divisible by 4. Next, 5280. Again, ano ang rule natin? We are looking for the last two digits. Ano ang last two digits niya? 80. So, is 80 divisible by 4? Pwede ba siya sa 4? Yes, kasi nga, 80 divided by 4, that's basically 20, no? So, to pwede siya. Next number, even bigger number. Again, don't be afraid kahit gano'n siya kalaki. Ang titingnan mo lang are the last two digits. You have 26. So, is 26 divisible by 4? No. Kasi kulang. 24 pwede, pero 26 hindi. 28 pwede, 26 hindi. So, ibig sabihin nun, ito ay hindi divisible by 4. So, ang divisible lang by 4 are 8 and 5280. Okay? So, again, this is all about speed. The faster you are here, mas mabilis ka mag-radical, mas mabilis ka mag-factor 3, mas mabilis ka ngayon mag-solve ng kahit polynomials. It's very important for you to know this. So, is it divisible by 5? This is actually the easiest technique of the bunch. In order to know if a number is divisible by 5, the rule is this. It has to have the last digit ng 0 or 5. Again, 0 or 5 lang. So, kung hindi 0 or 5, then automatic hindi siya divisible by 5. So, isa-isayin natin ngayon yung ating mga numbers here. You have 8. Ang 8 is not divisible by 5 kasi ang 8 is not 0 or 5. So, hindi to pwede. 7, hindi rin siya pwede. 5, pwede siya. 0, pwede siya. And itong 6, hindi pwede. So, X. Now, paano to nakakatulong? If, again, if you have a fraction na 5280 over 12326, then alam mo na na hindi mo pwedeng i-divide to sa 5. Instead, you're going to go to 2 and move along from there. Alright? So, again, it's very important for you to master these techniques. Kaya, stay tuned until the end of the video so you can answer yung ating quick quiz.
Alright, I hope you learned something new today. If you did, click thumbs up. Make sure to share this video with your friends, lalo na kung mag-exam din sila. And if you want a copy of the reviewers that I make, you can go to www.facebook.com/teamlyqa to find out how you can get one of yung mga reviewers that I made. Also, to attend one of the upcoming review events and or to join the online review program. And as I promised you guys, you can vote for the next lesson na pag-uusapan natin. Don't forget to hit yung I dito sa taas ng video na ito. And also to access the free quiz that I promised. Alright? Para ma-practice ninyo yung mga bagay na tutunan nyo na ngayon. Alright? So thank you guys for watching. And another bit of a quick announcement then. Since a lot of you guys were happy about the prospect of getting a free reviewer, I'm going to set up the promo na every time may madadagdag na 5,000 subscribers dito sa channel, I'm going to give you guys a free reviewer. So, may giveaway tayo every time may hit tayo ng 5,000. So, after 15,000, there will be a giveaway. After 20,000, 25, and so on and so forth. Alright? So, thank you guys for telling your friends about what you do here. Malapit na susunod na civil service exam. So, aja-aja. Kaya niyan. God bless you. Never stop learning. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye for now.